Here we have auditorium seats from the Sorapta High School in Sorapta, Louisiana. It's about 50 miles east and north of Shreveport, Louisiana. And with the cooperation of the assistant principal and alderman for Sorapta, Tony Mullins, we were able to salvage these out of the high school that's being demolished to make way for a parking lot. So we have to get these apart to store them and to refinish them to make them pretty again. We don't have a choice here, because when they put them together originally, there was about probably 3/8 of the bolt that stuck past the nut, and they just took a pair of pliers and broke it off. So boogers the end of the threads where you can't just undo the nut. But there's no way to hold the front of the nut because it's a smooth top, so it don't catch in your clothes when you sit in the seat. So that's what we're doing, restore these. And then once we get a set restored for Trace Adkins, the famous country singer, this was his alma mater. He went to high school here. Then we'll get these ready and they'll be available for y'all. Thank you, and we'll do more later. Hello there again. Well, now that we have these grinded off, now we're going to use a ratcheting wrench to remove these bolts and nuts off the chairs so we can get them apart, get them out of the weather, and get them stored. And then I'll sand them down with 400 sandpaper, give them a nice coat of polyurethane, and they'll be ready. All right, here we go. Top one came off. Slip into this bottom one. Gotta grind a little more. Use a little leverage. Carefully slip the screwdriver in behind the steel bracket so not to do any more damage to the wood, and just give her a little twist. I'm going to put stress on it enough to hold that bolt in place. Hopefully we'll get it apart here. There she comes. She's off. There we go. Trash, trash. These, the wood on these is just gorgeous. The sand in. All right, we'll do more later. Okay, today we're gonna sand these down with some 400 sandpaper. We got most of the gum off the bottom. So also nearly every seat had gum on the bottom. The older gum was pinks and reds, and the newer gum is blues and greens and some whites. So we're gonna sand this bird's eye here and this and the seat back. Just take the original finish off and try not to disturb the stain, and then we'll coat them with two coats of poly and see what that looks like. And then we're just going to use 400 sandpaper this time. We'll try that and see. I'd say it's a little something like Norm Abrams does on his Yankee workshop. But just be safe with power tools. Seat bottom first, I guess. So the bottom doesn't even look like it ever had a finish put on it. Barely. Alright, I'm sure y'all don't want to watch me sand, so I'll show you here later once I get both sides sanded and everything, and then we'll tack it and put some poly on it. Alright, later. Okay, we got it sanded and most of the gum residue off. Take some low odor mineral spirits, get our cheesecloth wet, and we'll wipe her down and see what she looks like. So get all the dust off and give us like a preview look, or what I call a wet look, to polyurethane. Any of the deep scratches that go below the surface of the finish, we're just going to leave. That adds character. We're not going to go crazy and destroy the original finish down the wood like I have to with the other ones, because they were painted blue. My Haywood Wakefield seats. What's this one say? D-A-K-H-A-N? D-A-K-T? Scratched in there? See, that's going to be cool. There's the seat. It's going to look beautiful. You tack them once with cheesecloth and mineral spirits. Let it dry. I'll hang it up in the bathroom and let it dry. And then you tack it again with a wax cloth. They just call it a tack cloth, I guess. And we'll coat it. Alright.
Come back to you later.
We got the first seat back sanded down, and then we'll give them a coat of polyurethane. Okay,
later.